Given these three main aims, you have then what they call the arts. You're learning four fundamental arts, which are driving the whole thing of learning, of the school, which is what you call the art of seeing. How do you perceive? The art of listening, the art of questioning, and the art of learning. All of which, he said, and that's how I picture it, like the four pillars of what he called the art of living. And that's marvelous, because look at that. That is not systematic in a sense. It's appealing to a quality of engagement that is profoundly perceptive. It is perception that's really aimed at and where learning is. And therefore, learning has an aspect of knowledge, but it has above all the aspect of not knowing as more primary, because it's where the new comes in. And the new is always there, if you like. Every day is new, if we only know how to look, how to listen, how to learn, and how to question. So the art of questioning was also very central. When he sat there in front of everybody, he also asked a question, right? So that question's were to be explored, and we were to watch, because the question is not going to be answered verbally, it's going to be answered by perception. So he would say that you learn far more from watching than from books. So you have to really keep watching, right? Now, I think that that kind of approach, which has many other aspects, right? Because then you talk about what is involved in relationship, how the central relationship is here, that is not in the relationship of authority. Because when there is learning, there is no authority, right? Because there's no imposition, there is no fear, there is learning. And I always took it that, like the Greeks used to say, that man desires to learn. Man meaning human beings naturally desire to learn. It's our nature to learn. Therefore, not to destroy, not to go against that nature, right? So, but that also means freedom. It means the sense for to learn, you have to be free. You have to be able to play around with things. You have to be able to make mistakes. And that you have to have, therefore, an environment that allows that. That says, yes, that is how you go about it. And you find new things. You are supported in that quality of experimentation, exploration, inner and outer. Right? So here you have this thing about relationship being central. And affection being fundamental to the wholeness of relationship. This was my experience. I didn't mention it the other day, but the feeling I had of being at Brockwood of freedom came in great part, and I think mostly, from the quality of affection that I experienced there. When you feel affection, you are free. That for me was a discovery. That in freedom, you also are, in affection, provides freedom, and in freedom you're whole. That was immediate. It's not a system. It's just what comes directly from engagement with other people in such an environment. And that's very beautiful, because as the old boy, Krishnamurti, found out in the Oxford English Dictionary, how wise the dictionary can be sometimes really amazing to me, was that he looked up the word freedom. What does freedom mean? And came up with that it says there, because I checked it out, tried to verify it. He said, don't take my word for it. So I went also to the Oxford English Dictionary and I looked at the word freedom. And he said, freedom, from the Indo-European root pri, similar to Sanskrit priyam, love. So the root meaning of freedom is love. Now you tell me, I felt it the other way around, right? That when there was love, there was freedom, right? And love, of course, means wholeness. It means when there is no fragmentation whatsoever and there is this quality of total interaction, no conflict, no sense of division, no friction. Then you are free, and then you are whole. And that's the heart of that education, with many other aspects, of course, that can be discussed. But if there is affection, then there is freedom, and then there is wholeness. And that's what this education provided, in spite of all these things, because the art of living was being worked on so directly, of listening, observing, questioning, learning, in that same spirit of freedom, with that overall concern for the whole and wholeness of existence. So that to me has always been something that I would like to see happening in every school.